Look at that. How's that for a nice fall wintery day?
An old Caddy was really smoking out the tailpipes this morning. Man, it's cold out. It's got frost on the windshield and frost is coming off of the car. It's melting now. Anyways, yeah, so we're just trying to get this taken care of. There's a windshield chip. There's two windshield chips, so I'm gonna get those where they inject the white plastic, or they inject the plastic into the hole. So I'm gonna be getting that repaired today. So I gotta drop her off for the week and get that fixed. So yeah, that's why I'm taking it with me today. Of course, we gotta get this off, and then it's a cold morning this morning. Well, just dropping the catalog off here. You'll see the stone chips right there, and the stone chips right there. Now, only place I was able to actually get a price on a windshield was down in the States, and they said $1,000. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna do, but I think a stone chip, $65 to repair those two is what I was quoted. So, and $60 to repair that. So, he said he's got a lot of projects on the go. Oh, wow. He wasn't kidding here. There's that, I forget what, 70 something Camaro. Wow, you weren't kidding about all the projects on the go, John.
Yeah.
It's Rick's Camaro.
Yeah, Rick's Camaro, this thing.
Yeah, holy, wow.
Yeah, like it's...
That's fresh.
Yeah, like, and like, it's really rotten.
Yeah.
Like, really, really rotten. Like,
pretty much that. Well, all the back of this was all gone, so I had to put all new stuff here.
Yeah.
And all around the windows up top, I dug with all the lead work. And
if it wasn't a CUDA, it wouldn't be worth it.
Yeah.
If it was a Nova, it wouldn't be worth it. No.
Well, and like the firewall's all rot.
Yeah.
The last guy that did it had all stuff pop riveted in. And
yeah, it did fluff and puffed it.
Oh, yeah. And like,
to put it lightly.
Yeah. And I weld everything solid anyway, so
yeah.
Nothing spot welded on. Or
yeah, no. Your attention to detail is.
That's why I'm here.
Yeah. You still haven't sold this.
What's that?
You still haven't sold this yet.
That's mine now.
Oh, okay.
I bought that.
Yeah.
I bought that off Rick's sister.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I remember the motor.
No, just that.
The 35 miles of the gallon motor.
That'd be nice.
You forgot the decimal, 3.5 miles?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Oh, man. Well, I won't hold you up. I know you're a busy man.
Yeah, well,
so
I gotta head out and move with my wife at 3 o'clock. So,
I got
another 6 minutes.
Oh boy! Well, this is the
S10
here.
That's the S10.
Yeah.
That's something I bought a couple years ago. I thought, be a quickie, make some quick money.
Yeah.
No. I ended up having to buy another one for the motor because this motor was screwed. And
yeah.
Then somebody broke into it.
Yeah.
Steering column was all screwed, so I got to put a steering column in it. And
well, I dropped off their Caddy, and she does not like the cold. She's been pampered all her life, and she has never had the cold like in Canada. So, anyways, I'm not sure what's going wrong with the starting procedure, but you go to crank it over, and in the start position, like it, when you have the key in the start position, it will it'll crank and crank and crank and crank. But as soon as you turn it, like as soon as you let go to the on position, that's when it actually starts up. It's like there's too much of a voltage draw or something like that. And anyways, when Blue Road's at it, it never had that starting issue at all. So I don't know what's going on there, if there's like a voltage issue or too much of a draw, or maybe the starter or something like that is starting to get a little wore out. But I'm sure somebody has encountered this before. But anyways, yeah, so Caddy will be there for the week, and I'll pick her up with the fixed windshield next week. And then I've also got to get that other glass figured out as well, what we're going to do with that. Because unfortunately, the guy that does the plastic injecting doesn't fix glass as well. So we'll touch base with John in a week.
Well, I'm at a secret undisclosed location, and there's a 56 Cadillac right here for parts. And luckily, I was able to grab a couple parts from this thing for my 56, but I was very, very fortunate enough to be able to pull some parts off of this. So it's still complete. I wouldn't mind buying the whole front clip off of this and the whole back clip as well. Maybe do some kind of project with it. It'd be cool for art nonetheless. And then there's a 50, I think that's a 57, because it's got really more distinct fins on it, but they've been pretty well scooped back there. Just like these ones, the backs have been scooped off of it as well, like the lights. But yeah, this is the underside of the hood, and at least now I have a template that's not rotted out. I'm going to see if I can get this one fixed, or at least get it fixed and or sandblasted and get some of mine patched up. But yeah, there's lots of old cars here, and it's not something you find every day. There's one more car I just want to take a look at and measure that passenger window, because my passenger front window is so mine's the more rare one, more or less desirable one, and those ones are just an inch too short. They're the same width, but an inch too short, and I would think, okay, I could just make one of those work, but unfortunately, I won't be able to have anything to for the glass to grip onto. So, man, I also got I was very fortunate enough to be able to get one of those rims as well, because my car didn't come with a spare rim on it. So yeah, I'm surprised it still has an emblem on the front of it. Usually that would be scooped off. I mean, the one on the top of the hood. But yeah, what a sight there. That's awesome.